The problem with this is like the job I have now is it's tough to do that because a lot of times I'm sitting on the couch because I need to like creatively catch up.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I can't just keep moving because you don't know what to do.
Here's why the Vlog Squad legally will never be the same. David Dobrik has a tumultuous history, having used the N-word and making fun of Asian people on numerous occasions. Many people find his videos and comments to be upsetting. A string of allegations against YouTuber David Dobrik have surfaced in the last month or so, each one seeming to be more shocking than the last. The Vlog Squad, who made a variety of posts, mostly pranks, has been chastised for their material, and advertisers are beginning to drop David Dobrik as a result of the accusations.
Yeah, maybe they do.
In this video, we're going to tell you the Vlog Squad will never be the same again. The video is going to be amazing, so make sure you stick till the end.
Okay, here's a good reaction.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Okay, well, it's gonna be more like this.
Oh my god, you're my favorite.
David Dobrik told fellow Vlog Squad member Seth in a vlog in 2017 that he was going to kiss a girl, but he set him up with YouTuber Jason Nash and forced them both to make out without Seth's permission. The video has almost 10 million views, and a year back, Dobrik played a similar joke on Seth, this time featuring Nash. Seth has recently come out to talk about these vlogs, since he has now gained the courage to do so.
Cindy, would you kiss me right now?
Yeah.
Really?
No.
Oh. Where'd you?
Maybe. Yeah.
Many of David's former teammates have accused him of being a tyrant who treats them like trash. Trisha Paytas, a former member of the team, revealed that the videos nearly drove her to suicide.
My reply to the DB from the H3 podcast called David Dobrik Debate. Now he's a complete, like he's a complete Simon. Complete dumbass, because he's actually sweet in person. He's just an idiot. There's nothing going on in there. So I'm only 10 minutes and 41 seconds into it, and actually there's like only like 2 minutes so far he's talking about me, and already he's like, this is like a sitcom. No.
Another former team member, Big Nick, said he got overwhelmed as a result of being bullied on a regular basis whilst working with David. One big allegation has been the icing on the cake for David Dobrik's slew of bad press. Seth Francois, a former Vlog Squad member, said that Jason Nash sexually harassed him in 2017 during a David Dobrik joke in which he was fooled into kissing Nash. I'm just training my mind to just be strong enough to just, like, completely get over it, he said. It wasn't my fault. I didn't sign up for it. I didn't ask for that to happen to me. And it did. But that's something that I just personally have to live with.
Jesus Corinna, what the fuck was that?
Furthermore, a woman came forward and said she was raped during the filming of a Vlog Squad video in 2018. She reportedly says she was given alcohol despite being under the legal age of 21 and became drunk to the point of unconsciousness. Later she said she was involved in group sex, which included a Vlog Squad member when she was too intoxicated to consent. Mr. Dobrik's channel posted a video that did not specifically display the suspected event until removing it. This is a heinous crime that has elicited a wide range of reactions. Many fans, and those with knowledge of the situation, have been calling out David Dobrik and asking him to answer after Seth Francois' first accusations against him were made public. Several magazines, including H3 after Dobrik's slam, as well as blogs and journals, contacted Dobrik's team in order to obtain a response from him. Every time, he said no. However, after the woman made the accusations, Dobrik created and uploaded a video called Let's Talk. It should be remembered, though, that he has disabled comments and the likes and dislikes. He said, "With the Seth situation, I'm sorry to Seth because, like I said, I just want to make videos where everybody in it, whether you're participating or watching, is enjoying and having a good time."
He's illegal! He's illegal! What's wrong with you?
He said, "I missed the mark with that one, and I'm really sorry. I truly, truly am. With people in my life that I don't film with anymore, I chose to distance myself because I don't align with some of the actions and I don't stand for any misconduct." He said, "I've been really disappointed by some of my friends, and for that reason, I've separated from a lot of them. I think with any video I make, my main purpose is to make people happy and inspire people. And I just never want anything to get in the way of that.
Consent is something that's super, super important to me. Whether I'm shooting with a friend or shooting with a stranger, I always make sure that whatever the video I'm putting out, I have the approval from that person.
Dobik continued, I'm sorry if I've also let you down, and things like that won't happen again. And I learn from my mistakes. And I also believe that actions speak a lot louder than words. You can take my word for it, that I'm going to change, but I'll also show you, and I'll prove to you, the mistakes I've made before won't happen again. Dispo is the name of the app he made. It's seen a lot of press, with the New York Times reporting on it. However, as a result of the criticisms and complaints leveled against Dobrik, fans and followers of Seth have gone to the app's website and review-bombed it, causing the review sheet to be reset to zero due to the large number of one-star ratings. David Dobrik is dealing with a slew of issues, one of which is sponsorship. With the real social media revolution, several big YouTube and social media stars have gone out and gotten sponsors to help plug brands so that they can gain exposure from the stars' followers while still being paid. David Dobrik was one of the most well-known celebrities, and as a result, he had a large number of sponsors. Brands, on the other hand, also lowered David Dobrik. HelloFresh said, We can confirm that we are no longer working with David Dobrik or any members of the Vlog Squad, and do not have any plans to work with them again in the future. Audible, Facebook, Dollar Shave Club, and HBO Max were among the other sponsors who ended their working partnership with Dobrik, according to Insider. Because of his previous deeds, he has lost sponsors, credibility, and more. The Vlog Squad will never be the same again. Let us know your opinion in the comment section below. This was all for today. Hope you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hit the bell icon for more updates and notifications.